Good day, my name is Martin Schweiger and I will today walk you through lesson 3 of our hands-on pattern drawing course. Today I will show you how to convert any grayscale computer image into a decent black and white drawing. This is done in only 5 minutes using freeware. Only that. This is a lesson for nerds and non-nerds. But let's jump right into the subject matter. We have here a web page, as we see it often in invention disclosures that are sent to us for drafting a patent application. The problem is now that most patent offices do not accept grayscale drawings like this one. It is also a problem to use these drawings because each time you make a copy from such a drawing, then there is some content lost. If we ask our inventors to give us proper line drawings, then they often come with dimensions and arrows and other information that we do not need. So we have the choice to either remove all the extra information here in this line drawing or to somehow convert the grayscale drawing into a proper line drawing. I will show you today how I do this in a very short time and all that with freeware that is either present on my computer Windows 10 or with software that I can download from the internet for free. Just to anticipate the result, this is the outcome and the quality that you can more or less expect. You still see that there are some parts of the figure, final result, that are not perfect, but this is much better than the original grayscale drawing. In fact, many patent offices would accept such a drawing at least for doing a prior art search and providing a search opinion. So, here are the steps for converting a black and white drawing into a line drawing. First, download the PhotoSketcher software at www.photosketcher.com and start it. I have prepared the PhotoSketcher.com webpage for you and the download button is here on the top right side. You can open it and then you can do a direct download of the full and 100% free version of PhotoSketcher. You install it on your computer and then you start it. I open the search window on my Windows. I type here PhotoSketcher desktop up and it would start. You have an input window on the left side and an output window on the right side. This is the default. We will leave this program window open and we open any grayscale figure on my computer. In this case, I have identified a grayscale figure on the AutoCAD webpage. It is here, just to show you how this works. This figure has definitely no copyright whatsoever, and I use it as an example here. What I do is I start the snipping tool here. In the Windows, I type in snip, and this would be presented. It opens here. That is a very important tool. I use it on a daily basis. I click New, Snip here, and then try to cut out the window. If it doesn't work, then you just press the New button here, and then you can do it again. So, you have cut out the grayscale figure from this web page, then edit, you copy it, then you proceed over to the PhotoSketcher software, and then you Control V, drop it here. As you can see, there would the parameter window be opened. And the parameter window has all these buttons that you can use to alter the conversion parameters. And you would immediately see the result in this little window here. All right, so the level of contrast, we put it higher. The important thing is that after you have used the window snipping tool to cut out the grayscale figure and you have pasted it into the PhotoSketcher software, you use the predetermined parameter set pencil sketch 2 bracket black and white bracket. We will do this. Pencil sketch 2 black and white. Black and white because, as you can see here, there are some color information in the grayscale and I wanted to remove the color because patent offices today in the year of 2013 still do not accept colors in patent drawings. By choosing the drawing style black and white, I have removed the colors immediately. Need to experiment a bit with the four parameters here. We have stroke length, which I would always like to reduce a bit because a long stroke length is not good. Then we need to darken, lighten a bit, the edge threshold up a bit, edge intensity up, darken, lighten. As you see, what is white will not get whiter, but the background turns a bit from black into gray. Here, the darken and lighten is very low. The background is very black. You just experiment a bit because we will later adapt the drawing anyway. Okay, let's try it out. What happens? We press the draw button and it will be converted. I'm still not happy with the lines. I put the threshold to very low, draw again. And now this looks much better, right? I would say that I'm happy with this result. And what I do is I save the drawing on my computer in my libraries, the pictures, photo sketcher image. I can close the photo sketcher software because we don't need it anymore. And after experimenting with these four parameters, darken, lighten, edge threshold, edge intensity, and stroke length, I have stored my result. And now I can edit the result on my computer using other programs that are there for free, or, which I prefer, I print the result and I continue manually the old style. This is the most time-saving mode that you can imagine. In the first step, I print out my drawing and I redraw the lines with a black felt tip pen. Just the lines. You don't even need a ruler. However, if you use a ruler, then it's even better. I find it sufficient to use hand-drawn lines. I use this very famous felt tip pen of the Stabilo company, German, the 0.88, and I use the fine one, which has a tip diameter of 0.4 millimeters. You can see I've done all the lines here already. It's quite good. In the next step, I steal my daughter's scissors and I cut out the drawing from the gray background. You can see my cut line here. I cut around here. This is very fast, in less than a minute. The next thing is I glue the cutout area onto a white piece of paper and I scan it. And that is done really quick. You can still see the coordinate system here, which was colored in the original. It is now black and white. You could also redraw the coordinate system because sometimes this is very useful to have such a coordinate system. On the other hand, you can use liquid paper to just erase it from that paper drawing and then scan it in. So, how does this look like in practice, and is there further information available? And the answer is easy. Yes, it is. Please check out the courses section on my webpage, www.iplawyertools.com. There's a membership, and all course fees come with a 1 month, 100%, no question asked money back guarantee. My name is Martin Schweiger, and I have just walked you through lesson 3 of our hands-on patents drawings course, how to convert a grayscale computer image into a decent black and white drawing. Goodbye. Thank you.